I'm ready, and I hope you are. Today we're going to talk about wine as a marinade for meats. This probably goes back to ancient China. You know, wouldn't you know they did it first? But wine is a natural tenderizer for meats, and that's probably where it first began. We first of all began to try and tenderize tough pieces of meat and prevent spoilage. Wine is a very important place in your cooking life. You see, it has a very important place. And I think the only way you can learn about the celebration of wine at the table and certainly in your kitchen, is to march down to California and go along the Napa Valley Road and find a big old mansion. This one is the Beringer Winery. And march in there for a tasting. They have a big room there where they will give you a little glass of this and a little glass of that. Just march in and saddle up to the bar and find someone who knows what they're doing and begin to ask them about the qualities and the experience and the flavors of particular wines. And when we begin to learn to taste a wine, you'll have a great time. This gentleman, who's one of the executives at the vineyard, knows how to taste. Look at him, he's gonna listen to his mouth. You see, lots of air in there so that the wine rolls about. Did you see that look of concentration? Good heavens. First of all, wine should be fun, remember that. So find a lot of friends there, people you've never met before, and you'll meet them again. They're driving up and down the road. You can taste, I suppose, 6 or 7 different vineyards if you take the time to do so in the middle of the Napa Valley, a wonderful place to taste good wine and thus bring it back to your kitchen and use it at table and use it in food. Now, today, I want to do some basic marinades for you. We don't have to worry about preventing spoilage now because of the invention of the refrigerator, which I think is probably just as important as the printing press has been to the intellectual life. So has the refrigerator been important to the life of the cook, you see, and therefore to all of us. Very important thing. So we don't have to use a marinade to prevent spoilage in order to cover over the flavor of rotting meat, of disgusting meat. We use it now to tenderize and to flavor. Let me show you. First of all, the basic Chinese marinade consists of wine, of course, a shot of dry sherry. Remember, this is sherry that's drinkable, very dry. I've got 1/4 cup in here. Then I'm going to add 1/2 cup, twice as much, soy sauce, and I'm using light soy. You see, this is not that muddy stuff. You see how light it is? It's not that caramely muddy stuff. All right, I've got 1/2 cup of soy and 1/4 cup of the dry sherry, very delicious. And then finally, we're going to add the 3rd part of the Chinese trinity, which is fresh ginger. This is a root that comes from the ground. This is called a hand, you see? It has many fingers. We're going to break off a clump, and we'll use a little bitty, looks like a little washboard here, but it's a porcelain ginger grater. And we want to put in about 1/2 teaspoon. And that's your basic marinade. Got that? All right, now you can do this you can put this in pork. You can do that with a pork dish or with seafood, with fish. You can do anything you want. Or today I'm going to do something with chicken for you. A marvelous marinade in which we add a bit of vinegar to our basic marinade, and we have a vinegar chicken dish. Let me put this aside and I'll show you how to do it. Now, start again with a basic marinade for Chinese food. And be careful, don't add too much ginger. I had one fellow in a Chinese cooking class years ago call me up, and he was complaining that his wife was cooking for 3 weeks for him, now Chinese style, and everything tasted the same. Well, she was putting in too much ginger. Ginger is supposed to be supportive, not, what's the word, heavy. All right? Okay, let's put a bit of, I'm running out of soy sauce here already. Okay, put a little bit of soy in our dish. We want about 1/2 cup of soy and 1/4 cup of sherry, a little bit of ginger. Now, the thing that's going to make this different for our fryer, our chicken that we're going to cook for you, is that we're going to add 1/2 cup of white wine vinegar. So to our sherry, soy, and ginger, we're going to add wine vinegar, and we're going to have a vinegary chicken. I know it sounds strange. Calm down. It's very delicious. It's very delicious. And we'll pan fry that. There, 1/2 cup. All right. Now, you don't have to do a lot in terms of timing with these marinades. I would think 20 minutes or so would be fine, but whoops, Come on, Smith, make a mess. But anything up to an hour would be fine. I said that mess because I'm splashing about on the counter. Something new, huh? No, always the same. Always make a mess. It's much nicer in the kitchen. You know I believe that. Now we're going to pan fry this. Chicken and vinegar and basic marinade. We'll pan fry it for, 6 or 7 minutes on the side, and then put the lid on the pan. Let me show you. I have a batch all ready for you. After it's browned, there. Isn't that gorgeous? After it's browned, pour the marinade back into the pan. But when you begin, you must drain the marinade from the meat. Otherwise, it's not going to brown. It's just going to lay there and bubble and steam. We don't want that. So drain the marinade from the meat, pan fry it in a little bit of olive oil, and then add the marinade back to the pan and put the lid on and let it cook for another 20 minutes or so. I'll dish this up for you. It's just delicious. And it's very unusual. I admit that. It's very unusual. Let's see. This is the one I want. I'm trying to find a bowl big enough to take all of this. Remember now, don't ever put a piece of metal in your good silverstone lined frying pans. And that, of course, is what this one is. The little wing. Do you know, we claim that a wing is something that's just to be set aside. But in China, the wing is considered to be one of the most delectable pieces of the chicken. And the old lady at the table, who's the auntie or the special guest, has the right to yell, "Dibsy's on the wing!" And she does. And you say it in Chinese, of course, otherwise you don't get it. Got that? Okay. Let me put this aside. I need some garnish on this. I think I'll just put a couple of onions on the top. You see, to make it look a little bit nicer. Just a few onions on the top and kind of a little heap here. A little color. All right, that's not very colorful yet, but we'll get some more. Thirdly, I want to do an onion beef for you. And this dish is so simple and so delicious. Let me get my pan hot first. Remember, you don't want to put anything in a wok. And it is pronounced wok, not wok. Wok is what you do with the dog. I'm going to wok my dog. This is wok. This is wok, as in Chinese frying pan. We'll get our pan hot here. And on my gas stove, I have had the gas company come in and open up one of the little jets so that I can get extra gas just for wok cooking. I want real heat. That's the principle behind the wok. The idea is to let the marinade trickle down to the center. Well, I'll show you. And evaporate. We'll have a little puddle in the center. So you can't do this in a flat pan. It doesn't work. And listen, let me tell you something. Don't you dare go buy one of those flat bottom woks and think that you're going to get something that's going to do the same. The principle behind the wok, like this, you see, means that the juices are going to come to the center and evaporate. If it's flat, then they're going to sit in a puddle. Remember the old line, stew in your own juice, because that's supposed to make you tough. Well, that's what happens to meat. If it stews in its own juice, it's all over. So I don't want you to do that. Now, we have a flank steak. And when you cut a flank steak to marinate it, you want to cut it across the grain. You see how stringy this is? That's a muscle under the side of the animal. So you want to cut it in little strips across the grain. Don't cut it with the meat. Got it? That's all there is. I have one already cut up for you. I want to get on to marinating that right now, because this dish is simply smashing. It'll absolutely bring about a dinner party. Here we go. Here's the meat, all carefully laid out as if someone else had sliced this. You caught on to me? Michael slices. I didn't. Isn't that beautiful? All right. Now, the marinade is simple. Basically the same thing. We want to begin with a bit of light soy. I'll put in 2 or 3 tablespoons. Okie dokie. Let me see if I've got enough soy to keep going on here. Oh, we're fine. We're all right. Good. I don't like these little bottles. I usually buy it in larger bottles, but today I'm stuck. All right. 3 tablespoons of soy, 3 tablespoons of dry sherry, and this is light soy again. I don't want the heavy caramely soy. And I'm going to do something a little bit different here, but first of all, the basic 3, light soy, sherry, and a shot of ginger. And then I'm going to add, because we're going to marinate this meat and cook it in a hurry, I'm going to add some sugar, just a teaspoon. That's like a pinch, you know what I mean? There, that's plenty. Well, there, that's fine. Just a double pinch. We'll do the job. Pan is getting hot here. Let me turn that down. We want it hot to start with, but if you get your pan too hot, you'll burn out the seasonings. You'll burn the oil off that is stuck to the pan from the last time you use it. No, I don't wash my woks. Never with soap. Only with hot water and maybe a green scrubbing cloth. But don't you do any more than that or I'll get you. All right? That's terrible. You'll ruin the wok. All right, now then, we have our basic marinade. We have a little bit of sugar added. Now we're going to add some sesame oil. And you buy this in any good Oriental market. I want a tablespoon. It's used as a flavoring. It's not a cooking oil. Just, and it's toasted, you see. Don't buy it at a health food store because it'll be very, very light. You don't want that. Now, you may choose the next ingredient. Either use red chili paste with garlic, which is this one, or hot bean paste, which comes in a can. Red chili paste with garlic or hot bean paste. You can buy either one of these in any good Chinese market. They'll keep for a long time. I'm going to use a tablespoon of hot Szechuan bean sauce. Just terrific. And the clincher, I know this sounds silly, but the clincher is a bit of barbecue sauce. And I went to one of my favorite barbecue places the other night, and they gave me a sample, so I just take a tablespoon of Randall's barbecue sauce out of the bottle. You buy your own or make your own barbecue. I don't care. All right, now then, we're going to marinate the meat in this sauce of light soy, sherry, ginger, sugar, and sesame oil. And let it marinate for 15 or 20 minutes. There we are. And now we'll get the vegetables ready for onion beef. Classic dish, Peking style. Peking, you know, was a place of the courts in China. For a long time, the royalty were living there, so the food was very, very good. And it had influences of a lot of other cultures. This dish really is more common in the Hunan region. But when it got down to Peking, of course, it became very elaborate and was served with beef and onions and good things there. Okay. Now, we want some carrots, just as a little bit of addenda here. And I'm going to Juliana carrot. Let me show you my new gadget. Have you seen my new toy? This is, puts this out. Xylus imports this thing. I think it's probably the label you'll see is Moha, M-O-H-A, Moha Company. What I'm doing is very quickly julienning some carrot. I just want a little bit, just a tad, for color. And look what you come up with. Talk about saving work. Look at that. Isn't that disgusting? It's just beautiful. Oops, that one. There they are. They're already. Okay, we'll have that ready to go in the wok. And, of course, I need some garlic. Have my garlic ready. And I need some onions. And for onions, I want two bunches of onions. And when you cut an onion Chinese style, pan's hot. Let's get the meat in there. I'm going to put a bit of peanut oil in the pan. Please don't fry with any other kind of oil in Chinese food. You want olive oil because it'll be too strong in flavor. And salad oils will, of course, burn. So we'll splash the oil about. Isn't this fun? I just love to do wok cooking. It's great fun. And put the meat in. And when you do beef, remember this is gonna go in a hurry. We don't want to take a lot of time with this. There we go. That should do us. Well, maybe one more piece. That was an awfully big flank steak. Might have to do this in two batches. I think that's all right. Isn't that beautiful? Look at the glisten on the meat. I love it. Now we'll cut up the onions that will go into the pan as soon as the meat is, it'll be done in a minute. Here's how you cut an onion Chinese style. Down the center, the long way, you see, completely. See what I've done? And then cut it up into 1-inch pieces. And that's what goes in next, you see? Nothing to it.